If you need to convert a PDF into separate image files, you can create a quick folder action with Automator on Mac, so it is always available for you. Search for the Automator app on your computer, then open a new document. You can use Automator on Mac to automate much of what you do daily on your computer with three different options. We're going to use Quick Action, which are workflows that you can add to Finder Windows and Services menu. I will select Quick Action so that the option will appear when I right-click on a file. Before I continue, I will go to File and save this workflow with a clear name PDF to JPEG. On the left, you have different libraries. Each library has a set of already created mini actions that you can use to create workflows. Since I want to convert a PDF to images, I will select the PDF library. Then select the Render PDF Pages to Images. Once I select it, I will drag it to the workflow area. Notice that this workflow has several options. I can specify the color model, what format I want my PDF pages to convert to. There are many more options besides the JPEG. I can also specify the default resolution and compression level on a spectrum from least to best. I will leave the defaults unchanged. The next step in the workflow, I want to rename the newly created images. I will go to the Files and Folders library and select the Rename Finder Item action. When I drag it over to my workflow area, I get a message asking whether I want to make a copy of the items before I rename them. I will say, don't add this step. Under the rename options, you can add a date, text, etc. But the option that I like to use is the make sequential and make all numbers 3-digit long, so it always sorts in the correct order. The final action that I want to add to my workflow is to move the newly created images to a specific location. I will create a new folder on my desktop called PDF to JPEG. And then under the Move Finder Items option, specify Other and find the newly created folder. I can run this workflow now, but the first time I do it, I will go back to each action and under Options, specify to show this action when the workflow runs. This can be helpful if you want to modify the workflow each time you run it. Now let's test it. I will select a PDF, then right-click on it and go to Quick Actions and select my new PDF to JPEG workflow. Since I asked for each action to appear during the conversion, I can see now the first step, specifying the format, resolution, and compression levels for my PDF to images conversion. After I click Continue, I move on to the next step, renaming my file names. And finally, I am prompted to specify the location for the newly created images. And voila, within seconds, I have 11 images created from the PDF. Let's preview them. Perfect. To finalize the workflow, I will go back to my PDF to JPEG workflow in Automator. If you already closed the workflow, open Automator, then go to File and open Recent to find your PDF to JPEG workflow. Since I always want this workflow to keep the same settings, I will uncheck the Show this action during run. I don't need to view each step each time I run it. Now, when I run it, it takes me exactly 8 seconds to convert a 231-page PDF to images. This was so effortless. Thanks so much for watching.